All right, so don't let the title of this video fool you. I don't hate 1911s. I actually really like them. But what I do hate is the 1911 guy. Hate's a strong word. Dislike. I say dislike. Just, you know the guys I'm talking about. Oh, the goddamn 1911's the best thing John Moses Brown ever did. You know what I'm talking. You know the guys I'm talking about. The guys that got them, but probably don't ever take them out and shoot them. You know? You know the ones I'm talking about. So, what reminded me to do this video was talking with a friend the other day. So, I thought I would just take them out, the ones that I have, and shoot them a little bit and talk about them. Now, you know, the design, you know, this one's a Kimber Aegis Elite Pro 45 ACP. Man, what a good looking freaking piece of engineering this is, right? Can't say enough about the aesthetics of it, right? Or, well, any 1911, I mean, you know, this is a custom job that a friend did for me some years back, the Chamber 38 Super. And then kind of on the lower end of things, I've got this Rock Island Armory 10mm. Geez, dollar for dollar, this is probably one of the best guns I've ever bought. You know, for what I paid for it. Wow. Whoever thought a $600, well, that's what they were a few years ago. Who knows what they are now? Probably $1,200 now. Yeah. Thanks a lot, Joe, and that horse-laughing idiot that he's got running for president now. But anyway, for the price I paid for this, wow. Fantastic. So, what's so great about the 1911? Well, it was a, you know, a engineering marvel in its day, right? You know, nowadays, I mean, is it the best thing on the market now? Well, I would argue no. And when I say that, I'm not saying it as a some, you know, great guru firearms expert, master, whatever. You know, just a guy that I know the firearms I like, I know the ammunition I like, I know the accessories I like, and I've got a few years of experience behind me. I know what I like. You know, I think the, you know, the striker fired pistols are probably a better design. They're simple. Disassembly, reliability, I would say are probably better than that of the average 1911. But that's me, so I can have my opinion, so if you don't like it, well, anyway. Not going to go there. So, yeah, like, this is a Glock 48. You know, if I had to pick between the two, I would take the Glock 48, you know. That's just me, so. That's really about all I got to say about those. I just want to shoot them now, so. I forgot a T-post, so you see my target sitting on the ground, so I've had to increase the distance that I want to shoot. Just got my steel target. Don't like shooting up close on a steel target if they're sitting on the ground. That's just, makes me a little nervous, so. I'm going to shoot from 25 yards. I'm going to start off with this 45 ACP. This is the Kimber Aegis Elite Pro. It's got a 4-inch barrel on it. Love this thing. Love it. So, I got a red dot up there that I'm going to shoot at on the target, and I'm just going to do a 5-shot group, see how we do, and then I'll go through the other two. And we'll do a 5-shot group, 25 yards. Group looks like. I know I pulled, I think shot three way off to the right. I'm settling in, and yeah, you know how that goes too. I'm gonna go spray paint up the target, and then we'll move on. wasn't a bad group for 25 yards. Pretty happy with it overall. For my first five shots of the day, I'm going to call it a success. So, this next one is that custom job that my buddy made for me some years back. 38 Super. I really like it. So I'm going to do something. I'm going to try this new magazine. And this is one that a friend gave me. He thought he was buying a 45 magazine. Ended up it was a 38 Super magazine, so he gave it to me. And this is a Kimber, so I want to see how it works in this. See if it see how well it functions. That's one of the things about 1911s, you know, that I've noticed is that some of them don't like certain magazines. You get failures to feed, things like that. And that's just in my experience, especially if you go with some of the cheaper magazines. So, but this one's a Kimber, so hopefully it works. It feels a little stiff, you know, going into the magwell, but not bad. So let's see if it it'll cycle at least five rounds. Here we go. Yeah, doesn't want to slide out real well, but you know that might come with time. The more I use it. All right, that group does not look very good, from what I can see from here. No big deal. We'll just move on. Let me go paint up the target. We'll try the 10 millimeter. I really love that one. I pulled one shot low and left, and you know, got to blame that on me. Can't blame the gun. So, but other than that, the group was a little bit high. Not terrible for 25 yards. Pretty decent group. All right, this Rock Island 10 millimeter. I've always been very impressed with this one since I've got it. It's accurate. It's reliable. It's smooth. It's got an ambidextrous safety, which my other two don't. I'd have thought in this day and age, you know, like Kimber, I can understand the custom one not having the ambidextrous safety, right? But Kimber, I would think, you know, maybe at this day and age, maybe they would start doing that to all of them. I don't know. Maybe there's a reason that they don't. But I do really like that ambi safety because I'm a lefty. Uh-oh. That was my fault. I can't tell from here, but that looks like the best group of the day with the cheapest one. I paid about half for this than I did for the one my buddy built for me, the custom one, and the Kimber. I paid about half, and it did not let me down today. So let's go and have a look at that group. So I went ahead and carted this one up here, the camera up here on this one, because of how fantastic this group is. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You know, that's that big of a group at 25 yards with the cheapest one. You know, the other one, you know, I had a shot down here with the 38 Super, and then the group was up here. And then I had one here, and then three there with the 45 with the Kimber. That is a very, very accurate pistol, and it's half the price of the other two. So whatever you think, sometimes you can go cheap and get a better handgun. Just saying. Not that it's better, but it's definitely more accurate. So just to be fair, hey, let's fire five more rounds from each one and see how we do. All right, we'll we'll just go right back through them. The Kimber Aegis Elite Pro, 45 ACP. Doesn't look like a terrible droop. Looks pretty good. I still don't think it's as good as that group I got with that 10 millimeter, that Rock Island Armory. So, paint up the target, and we'll move on to the next one. Okay, the 38 Super. The custom job. I don't think that group is as good as good as the one we did with the Kimber. So go paint that up, and then we'll do five more through the Rock Island. All right, I don't want it to be said that the Glock 48 is my favorite pistol. So I'm just saying I prefer a striker fired over. Over a 1911. That's just, like I said, that's just me. I do really like the Glock 48, but it's only got a 10-round magazine capacity. You know, maybe they make extended mags for it nowadays. I don't know. So, that being said, what is my favorite? Well, it would probably... My favorite Glock is probably the Glock 19. Favorite overall striker fired? Well, it's probably that little HK that I picked up a few months ago. It's great for concealed carry, it's reliable, it's accurate. That one's probably my favorite. Maybe I'll do a video on that one someday and kind of explain to you why. All right, Rock Island 10 millimeter, 1911. Group shifted a little bit on that, but it still looks like the best group of all three. I was a little bit to the right, but elevation was right on, and that may be different ammunition. I can't remember what was loaded in the magazine. This is a CCI Blazer ammunition that I loaded it back up with, so it might be because it's different ammunition why that group shifted, but it's still probably the best group. So I'll go up, carry the camera up one more time and look at the group, and then we'll probably just call that a day. So don't get me wrong, I don't hate 1911s. They're just not my favorite. And I say that almost reluctantly because I really do love them, but they're just not my favorite. So anyway, let's have a look at the target and call it a day. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's still a really good group. Just shifted to the right a little bit. Like I said, I think what I had loaded in that was some originally was some SIG ammunition, and then this is the CCI. So both of them still, you know, that group was right in here. Just a little bit higher, right? And this one's just to the right a little bit. So ammunition, when you get out to a distance, does make a little bit of a difference, but still, that's fantastic grouping, and wouldn't be afraid to use it in a self-defense situation. So anyway, now you know why I don't like 1911s, but you know that I love them. So anyway, have a great day.